going on YouTube? My name is M. The Bates, Pop and House Producer. Welcome on today's video, guys. I'm gonna show how to create Afro House beat. I'm gonna show how to make it knock, how to make it sound pro on your speakers right here, right now, together with me. So like, guys, like, if you find this video helpful to you, please thumbs up, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so whenever I upload a new video, you get notified. Because like, I'ma tell you this, this is part one of this video. I'll be doing part two. I'll be looking at arrangement, mixing, EQing, and leveling. So guys, make sure you don't miss out. Like, if you like this video, subscribe, hit the bell icon, because like, there's so many things I want to show you guys. There's so many things I want to show you on this video. So that's it, guys. I've already started the drums, so I'ma combine every masterpiece together with you. I'm going to finish the track together with you right here, right now. It's enough joking with me. Let's jump straight and do it on 3, 2, 1. Hey yo, guys, this is the beat. Like I said before, I already started the beat, so this is my kick drum that's playing. I added another kick, so it's a clone of the main kick drum. I sent it on track 2 and it sounds like this. But then I added another caster kick. I sent it to track 4. It sounds like that. It's a very low kick, you cannot hear it actually, but it provides something like the baseline of the drums. So I added another pack, it's a pack XP, pack SP I mean. Then I send it to track number 5. Then it sounds like all together with the eye, it sounds I added another kick, this is a dark kick, it sounds like this. So it's on track 5. Then what I did here, I EQ'd it, I high pass it to get rid of the lower end, because I don't want it to compete with my bass and my kick drum. So I like to high pass the sounds. I don't want that low frequency to compete with my bass and my kick drum. So I added this snare side here. It sounds like that. Yeah, that's it. So it sounds like this. Yeah, that's it. Check out the notes here. The last note is doubled and shift a little bit to the right by milliseconds, just to have that shifting. Then I added the hick. It also sounds like a conga. So it sounds like that. Yeah, that's it, guys. And all together, the drum sounds like this. Yeah, I like that. So like, I like to add every sound to the mixer while I'm composing, and I also like to play or like to compose when I'm on the song mode. Right, as you can see here, I've changed it from the parody mode to the song mode, so I like to do that. So now I'll add some sound here. Let's continue with the drums. So I'm gonna add sound like mass SP. I'm gonna add this sound. So I'll send it to the mixer. I'm gonna send it to track 8, so that I can able to mess around with the fade volume. So I like to add every sound to the mixer, so that I can mess around with the fade volume. So I'll mess around with the length here about 30, then the out completely up, so that I can send it to the piano roll and create some notes. So I like piano roll, not the step sequence. So let's create something, guys. C4 sound good, C3. So I'm gonna combine I'm gonna combine C3, C4, and C5, right? Yeah, I like that. So I adjust the volume a little bit down so that I can get rid of the lower end. Yeah, I like that. That sound more. So that's it, guys. Let's add something like let me check on my drums. So my add a snare. So let me send it to track 9. Send it, adjust the volume. But before I send it to Piano Roller, I'll adjust my pencil with the out about 30-40%. Okay. Then I'm gonna play on C5. Let's add something, guys. Yeah, right there. Put another note. Yeah, let's play. That sounds great. So that sounds good. So I wanna pan it to the right so that I can have that stereo sound. So I like to pan some of my sounds to left and right so that I can have that stereo hitting left and right. Stop that. So let's add something. I'm gonna add a wood cabasa. It's a sound that sounds like a shaker, but it's not really a shaker. So I'm gonna add that. Send it to track 10. Send it to track 10. Just like that. So send it to piano roll. Then I'm gonna synthesize something, guys. Let's see what I can do. Same note, okay. Put that. No, sorry. Go back. Just preview this and hear what it sounds like. That's the envelope, just I was messing around with the attack. And yeah. Fine. So it's on track 10. So that's it, guys. Let's see what we can add, or maybe I'm gonna clone this. I'm gonna create something here. So I'm cloning this cabasa so that I can have another sound that I'll send to the left, because I can have left and right. I want the highs that will hit left and right so that I can have the stereo sound. Add two notes down. Yo, that is so. I'm gonna copy the first part. Copy it right here. Then I'm gonna copy the second part to the last part. So I'm gonna do copy. To avoid wasting time, guys, just do that. Copy. So that sounds great, but I wanna separate it from track 10. I wanna send it to its own track. So what I do, I'll send it to track 11 so that I can pan it. That's how I do it. I'll pan it to the left. Get rid of the lower end and put some EQ too. I'll skip it and have this preset, get rid of that. See, I want the only the highs, I don't want the lows. So I'm gonna try and see what I can get. Maybe I can adjust the root note. Let's see what I can do here. Check that. Yeah, this is what I want. So I'm gonna turn down the volume a little bit. So the stereo sound is coming out. Let's see else what you can add. Attack shaker, shaker. This is every studio default sound. So I'm gonna go back to my page and see what I can add here. Triple shaker. Let me see that. Maybe I send it to track 12. Yeah, send it to piano roll. Let's create something here. Okay, I'm doing it. I want something like ta 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 ta. Yeah, something like that. Okay, so send it to track. So what I wanna pan it to the right. Yeah, sorry. So I can hear the stereo sound. So actually, the first vocabulary was the main shaker, so that it leads the other shakers. So the last two shakers, they are made for like left and right, so that I can hear the stereo sounds of the highs. Good, I like that. The beat is coming up, guys. I'm already feeling the beat, so almost done. So what I do now, I'll add a shaker. It's a loop shaker, so I'm gonna add it just to give it that extra spice, you know. So I want to add it to its own track 13. So I'm gonna down the volume a little bit, about 50%. So let's play it. So I like that. That's dope. So, but I feel like it's very bright. It's very bright. So what I do, I'll just pitch it a little bit. I'll pitch it a little bit, about 300 cents. Yeah, 300 cents. So let's hear that. So that's it. I like that. That's it, guys. I hope we are done with the drums. We're done with drums. Let's add some chords now. What I do, I'll load up Nexus. I'll go to one of my presets here. I'm gonna load Pier one. So I'm gonna send it to track 14. So I wanna play some chords. Yeah. So I'm using my MIDI keyboard, guys, to play some chords. I also like to hear from you guys, like, cause like I know it's not easy to play chords, like if you don't have like a music duo or a music background. I'm gonna show you a way on how to create some chords, how to play chords using like your computer keyboard or using a FL Studio piano roll. But for now, I'm just gonna put something together here. So I'm gonna copy that. Now hold shift and right. I like that, but the sound is very loud. Let me just put it to its own track so that I can just mess around with the sound a little bit. That sounds better. Let's continue with our chord progression. Wow, that sounds good. I'm gonna copy the last two notes. I'm gonna shift them down to C. Press and hold shift and the right arrow. Copy the first chord and paste it. Just like that, but very simple. Just copy, 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 copy. So I'm gonna continue with the chord progression, guys. I'll play like it's because like the chord progression is 32 bars. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna copy it, I'm gonna cut it and copy it and paste it to its own track, to its own pattern, sorry. So it's a like, this is 8 bars, this is 16 bars, sorry, plus 16 bars, that's 32 bars. So that's why the track stops. So what I do now, I'll cut it from this pattern and cut it, paste it on pattern 2 so that I can do this, right? So now the track will continue with loop. That's it guys. So I'm gonna clone this sound so that I'll pitch the other sound too, so that I can have that lead chord like that will be on top. This morphine, guys, is a plugin I like a lot. It has a very good quality sound, so I like to use it every time I compose. Like, so now I'm gonna go to PEX. I'm gonna look at PEX Philly. So this is one of my favorite sound. So I'm gonna play something here. I'm gonna play like a melody. I wanna make a melody, but very low melody. So this is the bass line of the melody, so it will sound very low, very enclosed. someone else. So it's very loud. Let me send it to its own track. As you can see here, it's not assigned to any track. Send it to track. So now it sounds much better. Just go back and edit it. I'm gonna add some notes to give it that extra spice. So let me add something like this. I'm gonna copy that. Like I said, copy, make things easier for you. Place it right there. Copy that. So I'm gonna add something. I'm gonna add like hypersonic. I'm looking for marimba xylophone. I'm gonna continue with my melody. So now I'm looking for a melody that will sound on top of that one. Melody that will lead that one. So I wanna add a marimba xylophone. I know it's very bright, so that's it. So I'm gonna add it. Yeah, that's it. So I'll play that note. It's A. I'm gonna play with A. Yeah, I want that. It's at the last note right there. I'm trying to figure out what I can play. I'm trying to get these keys right, guys. It's not easy, you know. But I see that, yeah, I'm playing with C4. Yeah. Now I'm on key. So I'm gonna go back to Nexus. Now I'm gonna add, go to my presets. I'm gonna add chili pad. I want a string or a pad that will like flow a very low to give that foundation of my main chord, so it will sound very low, but you can hear it, but it will be very low. So let's see what I can come up with here. So let's see that sounds better. Yeah, I'll play A there. Play G, play E, and C. Let's play that in here. Wow, that's horrible.
Let's try to change the root key. Let's see. Go to my settings. Let's change the root key from C5 to C4. Let's play that. Wow, this is what I'm looking for. So I'm going to send it to its own track 17. Then I'll mess around with the fade. Get rid of the line. So I'm gonna make it sound low, cause very low, 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 just to stabilize the chord progression, the minimal progression. I wanna clone that. Now I want a string that is very like high, it's bright enough to support the low pad. So what I did to clone that, so I'm gonna play some chord I'm gonna play E. That sounds good. Play E there. That's F. Okay, that's F. Go back a little bit. Yeah, that's it, guys. And another thing, like, if you find this video helpful, guys, make sure you subscribe, you hit the bell icon, like I said, part two I'll be doing a lot more than this part. I'll be looking at mixing, EQing, sidechaining, and leveling, and many more, guys. So make sure you subscribe if you like this video. Yeah, this is my high bright pad, so I think I'm done with the notes. So like, let's play and see. I like that, but I wanna edit some more bright on it, so I'll send it to its own track to get to the low end. I'll add an EQ bench 7. I would mess around with the volume, so get that like this. So let's play it now. Let's see how it sounds like. Yeah, this is what I'm looking for. It's really bright. So I'm gonna clone that. Actually, now I'm gonna play bass. It's 80 bass. Go to one of my presets. I'm gonna add synth bass too. 12, I mean. So I'm gonna send it to piano roll. Send it to piano roll. Why it's very light. So, oh, it's on track 17. It's track 18, sorry. So now that's it. Root note C6, sorry. So I'm gonna record it down, note and automation. So I'm gonna play it on my MIDI keyboard, then I'll put it down. 2, 3, go. Let's see that. So I'm gonna quantize it, but before I do that, I wanna get rid of the last note. Yeah, this is good. So I'm gonna quantize it. Press Control plus Q. Thank you. add something on the last note. I'm gonna add C3, that key, just to give it that extra space. Just hear it. So I'm gonna create another bass, but this one I'm gonna just cut it. I don't want it to flow like the first bass, so I may or cut it. I'm looking for strings and strings plus horns. It sounds like a brass, but it's not really a brass, but strings plus horns. So I'm gonna add just to support my melody. So let's check that. That's it, I found it. So I'm gonna add it. Copy that and I'm gonna paste it to the side, shift it. I'm holding shift plus the right arrow or left arrow to shift it to the left or to the right. add something else now. I'm gonna add the last part of the track, last masterpiece. So I'm gonna go to my preset, I'm gonna load R&B chord here, that's it. So let's send it to Piano Ron. Let's create something and let's roll it, guys. Let's roll this and hear how it's gonna sound like. This will be the last part of the track, so we are almost done. So I'm gonna create something here. Let's see what I can do, what I can come up with. But it's loud, I'm gonna send it to its own track so they can mess around with the fade volume.
Comment below, guys, because I also like to hear from you. I also like to hear you.